Now moving to the first law in circuit analysis, the Kirchhoff's current law, which is more commonly known as KCL. By definition, it is algebraic sum of currents entering a node is always zero. Now I'll just explain this using a demonstration. For example, if you have a building and you know that the building is empty and it is not storing any people, and there are some people entering the building and some people leaving the building. If I tell you that there are no people inside the building, you would always say that the people entering the building and the people leaving the building is always the same. The same goes for nodes. Nodes do not store charges or energy of any sort. So the coulombs per second or the current entering a node would always equal the current or the coulombs per second leaving the node at any point. So this is what Kirchhoff's current law states, that the amount of current entering a node and the amount of current leaving the node is always the same. So let me just show you an example mathematically. So if I have this circuit and I've already marked all the nodes A, B, C, and D, I need to find this current I. So as I can see that there is 2 amps entering the node A. So how much is leaving node A here? I can just say that because 2 amps is entering the node, 2 amps must be leaving the node too, because this is the only current leaving the node. So I must be 2 amps. I'll just show another example using the algebraic sum now. So now I have this circuit and I need to use the algebraic sum of the currents in a node and apply KCL to find this current I. So the first thing to know is, in algebraic sum, we can always use the convention that the current entering should always be positive and the current leaving should always be negative. So let's just see this node B, because there's so much current entering and leaving here, we can just use the algebraic sum here. So the first current, 3 amps. It is clearly entering node B, so I can write 3 plus 3. 2 amps is leaving node B, so I can write minus 2. I is leaving node B, so minus I. And 5 amps is clearly entering node B, so I can write plus 5. This is always equal to 0. And then I can use algebra to find I, which is 6 amps. So this is how you can use the algebraic sum to find the current in a circuit using KCL. I'll just show another example now. So in this circuit, I need to find the current I. So the first step is I'll just mark all the nodes in this circuit. So I can start off from this point, and this is a node clearly. This entire portion is one node. This is a node, and this entire portion is a node. So I can see node A because there's a lot of current entering and leaving it. So I can just consider node A, and I can write that I am applying KCL at A. So now I'll just start off with the algebraic sums from the left side. There's 8 amps entering node A plus 8. There's I leaving node A clearly, so minus I. There's 3 amps leaving node A, so it's minus 3, and there's 13 amps entering node A, so I can write plus 13. These are all the branches connected to A, so this is all. So this is equal to 0, and now I can use algebra to find I. So I would be 18 amps, if my calculation is correct. So this is how you apply KCL on a circuit.